Welcome, welcome, welcome. Thank you for joining me for another week of Outside the Box. I'm your host, OnneyTheCeo, the CEO, and this week I have a fire segment for you. I have a woman that is more than a model. She is an icon. So I want you guys to buckle up your seatbelts. You're now plugged in, tuned in, tapped in to Outside the Box. And we're back. And without further ado, I want to introduce my next guest. You guys, give it up for Model Bee Starr.
Hey.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for coming and joining us here on Outside the Box. I've been following your journey. You're definitely doing some dope shit out here. And so I wanted to ask you, first of all, I wanted to ask you, tell us a little bit about you. What all do you do? And how can we follow up with you?
Well, my name is Bee Starr. I'm born and raised in Houston. Mm-hmm. I've been doing this modeling off and on for maybe 15 years, I could say, about 10 to 15, because I started when I was real young taking star shots.
Okay.
So that's, you know, that's how I started to modeling and stuff like that. But I started modeling, doing videos and fashion shows, music videos. Oh, I said that. And opened up a boutique.
Okay. So you said you've been basically modeling since you were a little girl.
Yeah.
So how did it go? How did it transition from modeling to music videos? Or where were you in your life when that happened?
Well, first I started taking a whole lot of pictures, building a resume. So everybody would tell me, you need more pictures. I'm like, how many pictures do you need? So as I would take a whole lot of pictures, I was building a resume. People see that I'm working and getting different looks out there, and I would start getting phone calls for music videos.
Mm-hmm.
Never done a music video in my life, but when they contacted me, I was excited. The first video I did was, it wasn't a main artist. It was a Houston rapper. I can't think of his name, but we did a video shoot with him, and I was nervous, and that's when the acting brought out. Because mm-hmm. most of the music videos, they want you to do more acting than anything.
Yeah.
So that's when the acting came out, and I started getting that down and started hosting clubs, and everything just started expanding.
Oh, wow, that's dope. Mm-hmm. So it's almost like modeling chose you.
Yeah.
Well, everybody ain't all that blessed now. Now, so once it transitioned into music videos, like, who are some of the artists that you had the opportunity to work with?
I had an opportunity to work with Drake, Bun B, Rosco Dash. You remember Rosco Dash?
Lil
Scrappy. All that was when they was hot, like, way at the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
Slim Thug, and it's a couple more I can't think.
Oh, okay. Yeah, tell them they can follow up on you. Yeah. They'll be able to see. Yeah. Your resume speaks for itself.
Yes.
Shout out for that. Okay, so I actually have a video of you modeling. I want us to check it out.
Okay.
Now, on that particular video, you're actually modeling mm-hmm. clothes from your boutique.
Right.
Now, tell me a little bit. What's the name of your boutique?
1122.
1122. Now, how mm-hmm. long have you been in business with your boutique?
4 years.
Oh, that's dope.
4 years.
All right. So, since you started your boutique, like, where were you in life? Like, what was your aha moment to say, this is it. This is what I need to do?
When I realized that I was sending my customers, I had customers on my page, and mm-hmm. everybody would want to buy the stuff that I had on, but I don't sell anything. Right. So it gave me an eye-opening when I had a couple of boutiques inbox me, send me outfits, and realize, hey, you sending us customers, and they keep giving it to me. So I'm like, well, if I'm sending them customers, I might as well open up my own boutique and make my own money. And right. that's what I did 4 years ago.
Yeah. Okay. That's dope. And so now you're doing the modeling. Mm-hmm. You have the boutique.
Yes.
You're doing photo shoots.
Yes.
You're just, and you're managing being a mom. How is that? Congratulations, by the way.
Thank you. I'm not going to lie and say it's easy, because mm-hmm. it's not. Mm-hmm. But if I'm focused, you have to be focused, and I'm focused. So if I know I'm trying to reach to a certain level and I know I got people looking out for me, they motivate me. Believe it or not, when I check my DM, I get messages all the time saying that I motivate them. So it's mm-hmm. like I can't give up. Now I have kids now. So it's hard. Like, I be working on 3 to 4 hours of sleep every day. Mm-hmm. Waking up in the middle of the night, taking care of 2 kids, dropping them off, hosting clubs, going out of town. It's hard, but I get it done. Like, right. if you want it, you can make it happen.
Yeah. Yes, indeed. I'm proud of you, by
yes,
the way, for just
you.
Staying at it and, you know, keeping your shoulders to the ground, because a lot of times when you're a model or a singer or anybody that's in the entertainment world, entertainment is mainly a male-dominated yeah. industry. Mm-hmm. Now, have you had any tough lessons along that road of, you know, you can't help it that you're beautiful.
Right.
You know, you woke up like that.
Right.
But unfortunately, sometimes our beauty can bring out the beast in mm-hmm. other people.
Yeah.
So have you had any, like, things you had to overcome with that?
Yes, it... Really, at the beginning when I was starting, it happened a lot. That's why I said I was on and off. I was mm-hmm. on and off for reasons like that. Because
right.
it's like most guys, they want to work with you, but they want something in return. So that made me notice, oh, this is what these females really out here doing.
Man, what?
So I had to separate myself from that, and I check a lot of people from it. I won't work with you no more.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm more, I say right now, I haven't dealt with that in some years, mm-hmm. I guess, because the word get around.
Right.
So if I was to do something with a photographer, he'll tell another one, then they know to try me. So
yeah.
nobody has tried me since that since the beginning,
yeah,
and I'm
yeah.
cool with that.
Now, what advice could you give other thriving young models trying to get into the industry?
I would tell them, if you're serious about it, you got to do whatever it takes
mm-hmm.
to get to where you want to go, meaning if you have to come out your pocket for it, you know, because
mm-hmm.
not everything is free. I had
right.
to dig in my bank account and borrow money for stuff that I needed. If I wanted to look good, you have to pay for it.
Right.
You get what you pay for.
Right.
So if you want trash, you spend $5, don't expect to get something that costs a lot. So I tell them, you know, to stay focused and don't think that stuff is going to happen overnight, and you gotta keep going and don't expect everybody to support you on the way to the top
mm-hmm.
because they're going to fall, they're going to hate, and you're going to be on your own.
And, you know, you said something earlier in the interview when you said you just kept taking pictures, and you was like, man, how many pictures do I need? And one thing that I always tell any artist, whether you're a model, whether you're an actor, whether you're an actress, no matter what it is in music, I always tell them to build your portfolio.
Yeah.
Build your portfolio
mm-hmm.
because they might not, your favorite 12 pictures might not be my favorite 12
right.
pictures. I might want that 259th picture that you took 6 months ago that I'm going to pay big bank to get,
mm-hmm.
but you had it in your portfolio, so you were ready for opportunity.
Right.
So I commend you for staying ready so you didn't have to get ready.
Right.
Yes. Now, if there's something that you could do differently, what would that be?
What would I have been doing different? Maybe, if anything, bringing certain people around me, thinking that they with me, and not open up my eyes, paying attention to people who I had in my circle. I would have changed that, paid attention more.
You went right where I was trying to go with that. Because a lot of times people always assume when I ask that question, they think like a different profession. But it's not necessarily that.
Right.
It's like some people say, I just wish I would have started sooner.
Oh,
you know what I'm
yeah.
saying? It could be anything.
Yeah.
But mainly I'm looking for that. Like,
mm-hmm.
what nugget did you get from your journey? Because
mm-hmm.
we're constantly evolving. We're constantly
yeah.
growing. And when we think we've met that peak or that plateau, we can actually see higher horizons. And so we keep
mm-hmm.
going and keep growing.
Mm-hmm.
So have you seen significant growth in your boutique since you started?
Yes, I did.
Yeah.
Yes, I did. I almost gave up. Like, at the beginning, I almost gave up. It was hard. Then mm-hmm. I had a talk with one of the guys out here in Houston, a very, very, very known guy. And he gave me wisdom. He gave me motivation. He gave me everything that I needed to hear. And that's why I never gave up. Because I had to realize, sometimes I have to tell myself, you know, everything don't happen overnight. I tell it to other people, but I have to tell myself that too. Mm-hmm. And I just had to find different pieces and see what they like, you mm-hmm. know, in order for me to get it out there and close. And then when I came out with lingerie, it just took off. The lingerie right. is what made it take
I
off.
Know. When I went to your page, I was like, look mm-hmm. here. So you will have a faithful customer. I like, shoot, I might not look as good as you in them, but trust me, I'm damn sure going to try. Yeah. Yeah, so that's dope. That's dope. Mm-hmm. So what do we have to look forward to from BeEncouraged?
I have a lot of stuff. My manager is keeping me busy, and we have a whole lot of stuff. Like I said, I don't really like to speak on it because mm-hmm. it's one of those when I post it and just let everybody know right. what I'm grateful for. But definitely more me. I got some models I'm working with that's under me, and I'm helping them, you know, coming up with the modeling, getting them photo shoots, videos, and stuff like that as well. So. Kind of letting them have an opportunity, something that I didn't have help with. Mm-hmm. So I'm really kind of doing that and also focusing on me trying to do more, if I could do more acting, and he wants me to do some singing because I got a little voice in me.
Okay.
Yeah, so hopefully I try to work on that for 2021 to expand my
Well, we're not going to try, we're going to do.
Yeah.
You know how that go. We say try, but that really mean do. Mm-hmm. That mean that I'm already.
Yeah.
I'm speaking into existence today, so y'all mm-hmm. can look forward tomorrow because it's coming.
Yes.
Yeah. So I wanted to ask you now, I see that every time I went back to look at your page, I see that you've worked with different artists. Now, how do you manage those, like, late nights working and then still having to get up? And do you have like a distributor for your services, or are you trying to do everything in-house?
I do everything in-house right now,
girl.
Yeah. It'd be a lot.
Yeah,
it's a lot. And I also wanted to make a YouTube video to show behind the scenes of that.
You should.
Yeah, because a lot of people ask, like, they think I have people just out here just doing it, but mm-hmm. not knowing it's me printing and typing.
You need your own reality show, ma'am.
I'm doing all this and holding the baby, and she tearing the labels up, and yeah.
I bet you that's a sight to see.
Yeah.
So we have your clothing line. You have continuously putting merch. Actually, let's take a look. We have your website. I want our viewers to see mm-hmm. your website of where they can go and make that purchase. And that is 1122online.com. Is that you modeling some of your clothes there?
Yeah, most all of those right there are me.
Oh, man. You have so many different looks and you're so versatile. Dope. Now, is there anything that you care to share with your viewers, those that may feel like they can't do it? Is there anything that you can say to them, to that brown girl that's watching?
I would tell them to keep going, mm-hmm. you know, and make sure you have, it's important, you have to have positive people around you. If you have someone negative all the time and always got problems, and it's going to eventually bring you down. Mm-hmm. Even though it's not your problems, it will bring you down. Have somebody around that will motivate you, someone will keep pushing you, someone that you know for sure is in your circle and want to see you make it. Like, don't give up. Rather you got kids, or if you don't have the money, or you don't have the experience, all of that stuff comes with it, because I was just like that. But, you know, when you have the right people in your circle, you can really make it.
Now, speaking of right people in your circle, did you have a support team when you started, you know, with your boutique?
Well, my mom.
Dope.
Yeah. My mom, she was there from the beginning to now.
It's the same with your career in modeling mm-hmm. and acting. Yeah. Now, have you landed any movie roles yet?
I did a couple of skits.
Okay.
Yeah, I did a couple of skits, a little some here there. Yeah.
So you open to accepting roles and everything? Yeah. Okay, you know I'm a casting director for Mothers Forever Productions.
Oh, okay.
Y'all hear me? Y'all hear me trying to I'm trying to get that in while I can. Like, yeah, you know, I'm gonna put you in a movie. Let me
Okay.
So yeah, that's dope. All that Brown Girl Magic. Well, you know, I don't want to beat you with all these questions, and I just want to say thank you so much for letting me come and just dig all into your business and just see who the person is behind the face, because I see so much light in you and in everything you're doing, from the modeling to the boutique, just keeping things fresh and consistent. You've been on your grind for years, and just even when I went to do my research, I'm like, damn, she been on it.
Yeah.
So everybody know who Model Bee Starr is. So I'm grateful to have you on the show, to have you come sit around the round table and share your light. I want to remind our viewers to be sure to follow her on her Instagram page at Model Bee Starr 1, and that's 2 R's. Yes. And also, she has another page for her boutique at 1122 on Instagram as well. So I want our viewers to go ahead and follow that one. Like, see what you might like on there for the holidays. Valentine's Day coming up. I see a few pieces on there I might like. You know what I'm saying? Inbox me in some of them pictures, girl. And don't forget the website where you can go there and you can make purchases directly and have it delivered directly to your doorstep. Am I correct?
Yes.
So get that perfect look for the holidays. Show up and slay, honey. Go to 1122online.com and she will get you right. I want to also remind our viewers that we are on multiple platforms. You can find us on YouTube, Google Play, Google Podcasts, iHeartRadio, iTunes, Hip Hop Street, SoundCloud, Spotify, Spreaker, Stitcher, Pocket Cast, and you can also find us on Facebook. I want to thank you, Model Bee Starr, for coming on the show sharing your light all around the world so we can see it, and just keep on doing your thing.
Thank you.
Yeah. Keep on being a bright light in the dark room.
I will.
All right. Well, I'm your host, OnneyTheCeo, and you are Outside the Box.